It's the 1950s, and World War II has just ended. New technology is being developed. The space race is just getting started, and America has some new toys to play with. The atomic bomb. There was a whole lot of testing going on at this time. They were blowing up everything they could think of. They were blowing up cars, trees, the ocean. They would build up mock-up towns just to blow them up. And when they ran out of things to blow up, they tried to blow up the ground itself by placing a nuclear bomb underground just to see what would happen. And something interesting definitely happened. A manhole cover was potentially launched into deep space, creating a 65-year-long debate. I'm the Little Green Dude, and let's talk about it. Okay, so what's the story? So, back in 1954, the US government started to test with nuclear bombs. And after a few years of testing, the public got just a little bit concerned. You know, they were going on about nuclear fallout and radiation and all this stuff. So, the government had to do something about it. So in response, the US government started to place their nuclear bombs underground, in hopes that it would contain the nuclear fallout. But this has never been done before, and they weren't sure what was going to happen. So, in August 1957, they dug a long cylindrical hole into the ground. And then they lowered the bomb into the hole. And then they closed up the hole with a metal plate. And then they detonated it. The hole ended up acting like a cannon. The force of the nuke moved up the hole and hit the bottom of the manhole cover, causing it to be launched into the sky at extreme speed. The entire test was filmed on a high-speed camera, and while they were reviewing the footage, it was noticed that the manhole cover flew off into the sky so fast that the camera only managed to catch it for one single frame. A man named Dr. Robert Brown Lee saw the video and wanted to try to find out how fast the manhole cover was actually moving. Using some very advanced math that I don't think I could ever understand, he determined that it must have been moving at 6 times Earth's escape velocity, which is 146,638 miles per hour, or 237,600 kilometers per hour. So, like, really, really fast. Now, the issue is, the manhole cover was never found and wasn't observed leaving Earth's atmosphere, so it's unknown if it's actually in space. There are a couple of possibilities. Either the manhole cover was disintegrated, kind of like a reverse asteroid burning up in the atmosphere, or it slowed down due to air resistance and just landed somewhere on Earth. Or maybe it actually did get into space. There's no way of knowing for sure. There is one theory that could increase the chance of it actually reaching space. It's possible that the explosion actually caused the manhole cover to become curved, making it more aerodynamic, allowing it to cut through the air easier, which would increase the chance of it actually reaching space. But this is unknown. The government's never released the video, and without the video, we can't prove this theory. Now, I should probably mention, if this manhole cover actually reached space, it would have been the very first man-made object to ever reach space, as Sputnik didn't launch until October 4th, 1957. If true, I guess America did get to space first. Take that, Russia. To this day, it's still being discussed. And unfortunately, I don't think we'll have an answer. Not until we find the manhole cover or a video is released. Hey everyone, thank you for watching. This is the last video of 2023, and I got big plans for 2024. So feel free to subscribe if you want to see what's coming. I hope everyone had a great Christmas and a Happy New Year. Goodbye for now.